Hi guys, and welcome to a new video. This is of a new TV I've just purchased, a Philips 4100 series 32 inch slim LED TV, digital crystal clear, 80 centimeters. So it says over there, if you can see that, ready for anywhere, HD TV, digital crystal clear, 200 picture performance index. I haven't been able to find out any information about what that actually means. That's a picture of the TV with the feet. You can see that there. I'm not in my studio. I can't fit this TV in my studio, so the light's a little bit funny for this. This is the best I can do, though. So that bit's in British, in English. And this is the actual model it is. The 32PHH4101 88. Let's see if I can just give you that so you can read it. So that's that, and then there's some more on the side there. 32PHH4101/88 Philips brand. And it says there, it doesn't say anything there, it's all in Russian. Assembled in Poland, just up there. 6.2 kilos, that'll probably be with the box. The Philips trademark and Philips shield emblem are registered trademarks of that company and used under license. So I don't know if this has been designed by Philips or they're just selling their name to the people that make it. But I've never had any problems with Philips in the past. And at the price, I couldn't not buy it, really. It was so cheap. So let's just put that down there, just so you can see that, and let's show you what I paid. So I spent a while looking, and I got this one from Argos. See if it'll focus. There we go, from Argos. That's the model, and that's the price there. £160. I reserved it. They were selling about 100 a day at that price, or reserved, 100 were being reserved. So 159 for a 32 inch branded Philips TV. So the bargain. I'm using it in my spare room, so I don't really need a massive TV. So let's go ahead and look at what's inside. If you can see that, let's do it a bit lower so the light can get in. So let's just bend these flaps back. They're designed to stay open, which is another little feature. What I really like about Philips is they're just really well designed. They are a British, they were a British company. I don't know whether they are still or not. See if it gets in focus. So I just like the way that everything worked. All the menu systems and the tuning sequence and stuff like that. So when I saw that this one was at the price, I hope that it's made as well as the old ones used to be. So that's a 3-pin plug with a normal kettle lead on the end, as we call them in the UK, kettle leads. You can see that there. So that's just the 2-pin kettle lead. I don't think it matters which way it goes in because it's not got any specific connections on it. Any special keyways or anything like that. So these are the feet that came with it. On the picture, they're showed as that way. So I don't know if you can see that with a curve to the inboard. But they do have a keyway again on the top. And then the two screw holes. And they do actually say which side they are facing as you face the TV. There we go. That one says right. So as you face the TV, that one will be that way. That one will be that way, and that one will be that way. So they face inboard like that. So that'll be the left one. Yep, it says left on it there. And that'll be the right one. So those are the feet. They do look a bit like carbon, but they're not carbon. They're hollow plastic. Quite flimsy. I mean, I can't bend them with my thumbs, but they are hollow, not solid plastic. I guess that that knob there fits inside the bottom of the TV, and then you put your two screws in which are supplied. So looking at the TV, they go in the TV like that at each end, with the curve, with the angled piece facing inwards. I think they'll only go one way. So that's the feet. This is the bag of screws. There's two of those, one with each foot. There we go. They're probably Phillips head, I would have said, being European screws. But I'll let you know in the description. That one's the same. That's the bag the other foot came in. So those are the batteries, branded Phillips batteries. See if it'll focus. They're zinc carbon AAA batteries. RO3 1.5 volt. AAA batteries. And this is the remote that came with it. Let's go ahead and look at that. So it's a branded Phillips remote, obviously. That's the power on and off button. That's all the other functions. I haven't actually plugged it in yet. This is literally an unboxing. So that's the navigation buttons. They do feel quite a nice remote. And there's been money been spent in the right places. The decent quality strength of those feet. And I mean, for, what did I pay? £159. I mean, you're lucky to get a branded one at all at that sort of price, especially a 32-inch. So that's the remote there. So on the back, you just open it there, and the batteries just go in the back there. See if I can... So AAA, RO3, 1.5 volt. It says something there as well, if that's of any use to anyone. So that's the remote. So let's go ahead and unbox it. So let's turn it upside down. That's the instruction booklet. So we'll go through that at the moment. Well, I've got a TV upside down in a box. With me, I'm just moving the box out of the way. So important instructions there, customer information. So let's go ahead and just lie this down a minute and see if I can find the so let's just take the bottom off. I'm just guessing here, I haven't actually looked at how it says to take it out. So I don't know if you can see that. Let's just move the whole thing out of the way. One of the reasons why I bought this as well is because it only uses 30 watts, which is quite low for even for an LED TV. Let's see if you can have a close up of that there. That's the information sticker on the back. We just move this bag out of the way because it's crinkly. So that's the information sticker on the back there. See if it'll focus in. Digital Dolby Plus. And then the model. Serial number. And then there's the mount in the middle, I'm guessing, for the to fix it to a wall. And then it even has a pull tie on the back to hold your cables, so you can connect it to which this bit here, which is the important bit, which is all the connections. It's not all of them, I think there's another one on the side as well, but there's HDMI 1 there at the top, HDMI 2, digital audio out, a Freeview, whatever that is, and actually a Scart. They're very, very unusual to get a Scart on a new modern TV now. But the cheaper ones do tend generally come with them. I was looking at an LG TV and that only had one HDMI connection and one Scart socket, which was pretty useless really, for about 250 quid. So the audio in there, the DVI, and the TV antenna there down below. So there is actually another two ports in the side there. The headphone jack there, I don't know if you can see it, the USB. See if it'll go, if it'll focus in. USB and the CI connector, whatever that is. Let's get to the front and see what it looks like. There'll be a lot of reflection on this. Yeah, it's probably not that good idea too. So let's just show you that connection, that sticker on there, of what it actually is. So it's a Philips. Just bear with me, it's quite heavy to hold still. And it's an A plus rating. And then it's 30 watts. So 32 inch. And that's it basically. It says there, Philips. And let's have a look at these mounting plates on the bottom. So there's cooling fins on the left and right there. Actually, yes, it is cooling fins, but the speakers are in there as well. And they actually look quite a decent size. I mean, I've had an old Philips TV I had Denon speakers in it. So who knows, we might be lucky and have 15 watts of Denon speaker. Obviously, I don't know if they are or not without opening it up, and I'm not going to. So that's the model number on that side. So one speaker's there, and then the foot mount's there. I don't know if you can even see in to see the speaker. It's almost, the speaker starts there and ends there, and it goes around, sorry, the speaker starts there on the holes and ends there and goes all the way around. So it's quite a big speaker. I would say it's a good 85 mil long. If you can see that, you probably can't. 85 mil long by probably 20 mil left to right. So there's two of them. There's one there, one there, one there, and one there. And I think, because there's no room on the front, I think that is the on and off button there. So it's, that's the on and off button, I think. So that's just a quick unboxing review. What I will do is go into more details in the description and link to Philips's website as well with better specification information. And when I get it up and going with my Roku 3 player, I'll show you what it looks like. So thanks again for watching, guys, and check back soon. Cheers.